Hello everyone, welcome to CAD. In this video, we are going to see how to use the CAD software and NextCAD. So if you are not yet subscribed to our channel, please do like, share and subscribe to our CADness YouTube channel for more updates. So let us go for the design environment and let us see how to use the NextCAD software.
For this, I have created my features previously. So here I'll be going for new, go for assembly and name your assembly part. Give it as OK. And now here you'll be loading your components. That is the first component I'll be loading here. Give it as open. The first component I'll be loading my vice body. Give it as OK. And as I said, the first component always should be taken as observed origin, then give it as OK. Like this, your component will be specified in a origin place. Under assembly constraints, fix your first component, give it as OK. Then the next component, I will be going for add new, open. Here I am taking vice jaw as my second, give it as OK. In the placement position, we'll be selecting as Y constraints. Again, give OK. Here you can see our component has been loaded. With the help of touch or align option, I'll be moving it as I required. Like this, I have taken. Now, I'll be going for touch or align option and I'll be aligning my ends. That is, I'll be rotating my feature and you can see this face should align with this face like this, and here I'll be reversing my constraints. Why? Because the hole should be on the other side. Reverse constraint like this, then go for move. I'll be moving like this, and then again I'll go for align option itself and I'll be aligning my faces. Say this face, and then my bottom face should be aligned in reverse direction like this. Now it has been aligned. Now you can go for the distance between two component. For that, we'll go for distance and I'll be selecting the faces, this face and then this face. I'll be giving the distance between these two faces as say 25. Give it as OK. Like this, you will be constraining your second part. And now I will be loading my third part. Add. Here I will be loading, that is jaw screw. Give it as OK. Here also placement should be by constraints. With the help of assembly constraints, that is touch or align, I will be moving my component like this, then I'll be constraining them. Go for touch or align. Here I'll be selecting the center axis, that is center line of my jaw screw, and also the center line of my hole, that is in the base feature. The next I'll be go for touch option, and then we'll be aligning the faces. Say this face should touch this face. Like this, you will be aligning your third component, then give it as OK. Then the next component we are loading here, go for add, open. Here I will be selecting my screw bar, give it as OK. With the help of assembly constraints, I will be constraining, will be assigning the center lines, the center line of this and the center line of hole in my jaw screw like this, and also I'll be moving it towards the center. In the upcoming session, I'll show how to make it to the center. Give it as OK. Next, I'm loading my one more component, that is bar gloves. Okay. Again, with the help of assembly constraints, I'll be constraining my component. Align the center line. With the center line of bar screw or screw bar, like this. And also I'll be aligning the faces. So go for touch here, rotate your component, align this face with this face. So this is how you will be constraining your next part. Then again go for add component. You will be adding one more component here. In the same way, you are adding one more component to the other end. Here I am loading a different component. Say clamp plate. Give it as OK. Rotate your component. Here you'll be having your component under the beneath. Move the component as your requirement. Like this. Then go for assembly constraints. Touch your align. You'll be aligning the center line with the center line of the hole feature here. Again, the one more hole, that is the center line of this hole with the center line of this, like this. Then again go for touch option. We'll touch this face with the bottom face of vice jaw, like this. And next, you'll be inserting your base plate. Go for add component again. Base plate, open. With the help of move component, move your component as your requirement. The next we will be constraining, that is the center line of this hole along with the center line of the base plate. Like this. So this is how you will be constraining your base plate. And next I am going to pattern component. I'll be selecting my component pattern and also the direction, that is I'll be specifying the distance. The distance between two holes is 44. Give it as OK. So now you can see my base plate has been fixed. So by this, the assembly of bench vise will be completed. So this is all for now. Let's meet in a next video. Thank you.